is that don't look at the top. It is the first prison's table, but it's certainly not from Pine's Royal Residences. It's how it is today. So forget that. Just look at the thing. Look at these curtains. So at Hampton Court, here is that style of curtain, which was historically called the festoon curtain. I think they're called Austrian blinds today. And this is the style of window for which they were originally created. This is a very 1680s is the first date that we, or we went around the 1680s, is the first date for this style of, they were used to be called draw-up curtains. And there is a style that came from France. And when the fire at Hampton Court happened in 1986, there was a decision to restore the apartments to the King's apartments, which were burned, to the King William's time when he was there. So we're talking about 1700. And this is partly because the mirrors, the furniture, the canopies still survive. And I'm showing you this image here. This canopy here, this is from the, that's from the Pines Royal Residences, so I've put my titles in the wrong place. This is a wonderful source of information that it was watercolours done by somebody called, that we call the Pines Royal Residences. And of 1819, and that canopy is still in the room today. There are actually two canopies at Hampton Court, all surviving from 1700. This is really important. So if you have surviving evidence, that's, you know, because what we're talking about, sorry, I should start in a straight line really. What I showed you that previous slide for is what I want to tell you about the restoration, or the recreation, I should say, of the window curtains. I mean, this is what we're talking about, the recreation of these, nothing of which survived at all, nothing at all survived of the original. So what you had to look at was, what is the surviving evidence? What we knew, they were pull up, draw up curtains, but you know, what could they possibly have looked like? And that's when you need to look at what originally survives in the house so that you can get some idea. And this is a canopy. Now I must tell you a funny story. This canopy now, which when I say it survives, the back cloth doesn't survive, the valance survives, the embroidery survives, but that's been reapplied to a backing of crimson damask. The crimson damask now, the back cloth, comes right down to the ground. It was replaced in 1960. And in 1960, it was they copied it like this, and it wasn't English. Government?
PSA.
Said, oh, that looks ridiculous. Have it coming down to the floor. So it's come down to the floor. That is when you're not using historical evidence. So anyway, that's not something I was going to tell you.
Was it meant to be a throne?
It's a canopy. Yes, it's on a throne. Okay. So the throne would be either side. You'd have two chairs either side, two stools either side, and a footstool in front, and then that would be the throne. I mean, this is how it looked at the time. Not quite in the right placement, but this was the canopy. But I'm showing it to you because this canopy, the actual tester, or whatever you call it, the roof of the canopy, still survives with the original fringe. The wonderful description is called a crimson silk, twisted, tufted, faggoted silk fringe. Ooh. And that's what was on the fringe. And what does survive are the accounts for the room. And the accounts survive for the canopies, and it also survives for the window curtains. And the description of the trimming on the window curtains matched the trimmings on the canopy. Mm. So we realised we had to copy that to have the trimmings on the side.